The question is asking to draw out all constitutional isomers for C5H12. Since this chemical formula fits in the general formula of CnH2n+2, that means C5H12 is an alkane. We're going to use a systematic way of drawing the isomers, that way we won't accidentally leave out any structures. Let's start by drawing a 5-carbon chain, meaning 5 carbons connected straight in a row. Now, if we were to draw 4 carbons and then we stick a carbon at the end like this, is it an isomer? Well, let's see. We can count the carbon chain and looks like it's 5 carbon connected straight in a chain. Same goes to if we were to draw 4 carbons straight in a row and we stick a carbon at the front. It will be 5 carbon chain because we can count 5 carbons continuously. So the lesson here is to not stick a substituent, the stuff hanging there, at the end of the chain. Now let's move on to a 4-carbon chain. To avoid accidentally drawing out a 5-carbon chain, the remaining carbon should be stuck to the second carbon, not at the front or at the end. Now let's see if I move the substituent to the third carbon, will we get a different isomer? The structure on the top has 4 carbons and it has a substituent on the second carbon. The one at the bottom, when we count starting from the end that is closest to the substituent, we can see that it's actually the same structure, 4-carbon chain with substituent on the second carbon. So it looks like we only have one structure for 4-carbon chain. Moving on to 3-carbon chain, the only way to place the 2 remaining carbon is to stick them on the second carbon. So we get a 3-carbon chain with 2 substituent like this. Let's place in the hydrogens. With the 5 carbons, the first carbon is connected to only one carbon. Since carbon can make 4 bonds, that means the first carbon will be attached to 3 hydrogens. The second carbon is connected to 2 carbons, that means it has 2 remaining bonds. Same goes to the next 2 carbons. The last carbon has 3 bonds. Putting in all the hydrogens, here's the condensed structure of the first isomer. Moving on to the second isomer, the 4-carbon chain. Here are the remaining bonds that each of the carbon has. And here's the condensed structure for the second isomer. Last but not least, the third isomer, the 3-carbon chain. After putting in the remaining bonds and filling up with hydrogens, here's the condensed structure. There we go, the 3 isomers for C5H12. I hope you find the video helpful. Do subscribe, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.